This video shows you how to change your child's Astral ventilator humidified single limb passive circuit at home. We will also discuss how to do a circuit test called a learned circuit on your machine. A circuit is the tubing that connects your child's breathing machine to their tracheostomy. This connection is used to help your child breathe. If your child uses a home ventilator to help them breathe, you'll have monthly responsibilities involved to keep the equipment clean and safe. Every ventilator needs to have its circuit changed on a regular basis. Your doctor and home care medical equipment supply company will tell you how often to do this. The first step is to clean your hands well. Wash your hands with soap thoroughly for 15 seconds in warm water. This is important to keep your child healthy as you are changing their equipment. Next, apply clean, appropriately sized gloves. If your doctor says it's safe, you can take your child off the ventilator during the circuit change process. But if it is not safe for your child to be off their ventilator for any amount of time, you must place your child on their second ventilator prior to beginning a new circuit change. When your child is comfortable breathing on their own or with their spare ventilator, wash your hands again and apply new gloves. Sanitize the setup table prior to use with cleaning wipes. Grab the equipment you will be needing, get a new ventilator filter, ventilator circuit, humidifier water chamber, sterile water container, exhalation valve, blue guard, OmniFlex, and inline suction. First, remove the humidifier water chamber from the packaging and carefully slide it onto the top of the humidifier. The chamber typically clicks when it's far enough in. Gently tug on the chamber to make sure it is in securely. Make sure the chamber is inside of a securing lip on the humidifier and not accidentally above them. The bacterial filter is the first part you want to place on your ventilator. Place it directly on the inhalation end of the machine. It should only fit one way. Next, grab the smaller of the two circuit tubes. Place one end of the tubing onto the bacterial filter. Place the other end onto one of the two humidifier chamber openings. It doesn't matter which end of the ventilator tubing you use. You can attach the tubing to either chamber opening. Just make sure your tubing has a healthy bend in it and is not squished or stretched tight. After that, grab the longer ventilator circuit tubing. This circuit often has a Y-shaped end. Take the hollow opening of this side and place it onto the other opening of the available water chamber. If you forget which end of the tubing to use, remember the phrase, Y away from your child. The next step is powering the wires that are inside the circuit. Locate this black power plug-in that is hanging off the humidifier chamber and plug it into this area with pins facing right side up. The plug-in should be able to slide into place without resistance. Make sure it is facing right side up so the pins don't bend. Each water chamber has two temperature probes for those openings that should already be attached on the side of the device. Before placing the first shorter temperature probe into the circuit tubing, clean it for 10 seconds with an alcohol wipe. Next, take the shorter probe to place it into the correct opening. Insert the probe like this with a bump in the probe facing up. Clean the second temperature probe as well with an alcohol wipe. This one is at the end of the long cable. Place the probe into the opening at the other end of the longer ventilator circuit tube. You may have to twist the probe as you push it into the opening in order to get it completely inside. Once you've gotten this far, the circuit should look like this. Next, you must do what's called a learned circuit test before connecting anything else to the circuit. To get to the circuit test, first move to your touchscreen. The first thing you want to press is the setup option visible here. The correct option looks like two check marks. After pressing setup, follow the blue marker across the screen to the left side and press the circuit option. After pressing the circuit option, look at the middle row here at learn circuit. Note you can see here when the last learn circuit test was done. This is a good thing to come back to check regularly. Now we're going to do a learn circuit test. Step one is to press start. The machine instructs you on screen to turn off the oxygen. Go ahead and do so. Afterwards, remove the entire circuit from the inhalation side. After you're done with that, press continue. Step two is to reattach the circuit to the inhalation side, then press continue. Step three is to block the other end of the circuit. Pick up the long Y circuit and with a clean, gloved hand, cover the opening and hit continue. After this step, the machine will show the results of the test. If the screen shows three green check marks, this means the test was successful and the machine can be used. Do not use the ventilator if you have any red or yellow symbols like shown here. Please call your home care ventilator company for assistance if necessary. Once the test is complete and the machine passed with three green check marks, move back to your circuit and attach the exhalation adapter with the blue guard attached. The blue guard is used to make the exhalation adapter safer by making it harder to cover up and block on accident. To attach, place the exhalation adapter into the tubing with the end that's left open, having a plastic internal ring to attach to the next piece. The direction to attach the exhalation adapter may differ depending on the size of the pieces your home medical company gave you. Next, attach the OmniFlex tubing if approved by your doctor. The OmniFlex piece helps the circuit pull less on the tracheostomy tube, and it makes the circuit more flexible. Finally, grab a sterile water bag. Take the spike hanging off the water chamber and place it inside the water bag's opening. After the spike is safely inside the water bag's opening, hang it carefully above the ventilator. You should see the sterile water naturally start draining into your water chamber through the spike and connecting tubing. Your Astral is now set up and ready for use. Press start on the screen to begin ventilation before attaching it to your child, and don't forget to turn on your humidifier.